Now that we understand the happen before relationship and the transitivity of happen before relationship, I also want to introduce this notion of concurrent events. That is, concurrent events are events in which there is no apparent relationship between the events. So for instance, I'm showing you two nodes of the distributed system. A is an event on one node and B is an event on another node. And you can see that since A and B are not events on the same node, we cannot apply the sequential process condition to say that there is an ordering between A and B. And by the same token, since A is an event here, B is an event here, and there is no communication between these two guys that connects these events in any shape or form, either directly or transitively, there is no ordering between A and B. And therefore, these two events are concurrent events, not sequential events, not connected by the happened before relationship, but they're concurrent events. So in other words, we cannot say anything about the ordering of A and B in the distributed system. So this is the fun thing about a distributed system, is that this happened before relationship, which looks at either events on the same process or events across processes connected by communication, and the transitivity of the happened before relationship through the native happened before relationships, gives at best a partial order for all the events that are happening in the system. So there is no way for us to derive a total order by looking at the events that are happening on the same process or just looking at the events that are happening on the different processes in the distributed system. And this is a very good example why it's impossible to get a total order for all the events that are happening in the distributed system, because there are events that are going to be concurrent. That's the nature of the game, that these processors are executing asynchronously with respect to one another, and therefore the event that is happening over here, you know, if I want to look at wall clock time in one execution of the distributed program, it's possible that A in real time happened before B, but the same program when I execute it again the second time around, it could be that this event B happened before A, and therefore these two events are called concurrent events. So, important point about this concurrent events and the happen before relationship is that in structuring a distributed algorithm, it's important to recognize what events are connected by the happen before relationship and what events are concurrent events. And once you have an understanding of these two concepts, then you can build robust distributed systems and robust applications. Because if you have any assumptions about the ordering of events that are unconnected by communication like this, that can lead to an erroneous program. So one of the bane of distributed programs is synchronization and communication bugs and timing bugs. And this is a classic example of a timing bug that you can have. If you mentally think that A happened before B and that's the way you want it to happen, it may not happen because these two events are concurrent events. Now that I've introduced to you all the important basics of events and ordering of events in distributed system, it's time for another quiz.